In this training presentation, we're going to cover why it's important to report impacts to the National Land Grant Impact Database and how to write and submit good impact statements. So this training can help researchers and extension educators provide higher quality impact material. This training can also help inputters select or compile or revise good impact statements to enter into the database. And it can help the database's assigned reviewers understand what to look for as they review and suggest edits for submitted impact statements. So why is impact reporting important? Impact reporting provides accountability to funders and stakeholders. The National Impacts Database provides a publicly accessible repository of impact statements that demonstrate the importance and value of the land-grant university system. Describing the positive impact of research and extension can make people interested in and excited about science and can generate support for institutions and programs. Impact reporting can also be a tracking system for projects and programs. Reflecting on impacts can help monitor progress and steer projects and programs forward. Showing a return on investment can often improve the chance of future funding opportunities. Reporting impacts is also important because impact catches people's attention. Often the people reading reports are busy, distracted, and bombarded with information. They're most likely not an expert in your field of research, so they probably aren't looking for all the nitty-gritty details of your work. And that's why impact statements are so important. Impact statements answer the question, so what, or who cares? Impact statements allow you and others to share your work in a way that is digestible and resonates with audiences. Good impact statements can be easily tweaked and repurposed for a variety of uses and audiences. Funding agencies, the media, and others search the database regularly to find material for stories or other promotional materials. The USDA and other funding agencies use impact statements in reports and blogs, social media, et cetera, and in talking points for the secretary. Impact statements are also compiled in briefs for legislators. Impact statements can be used in or used to pitch stories for local newspapers or for special interest magazines. Universities can use impact statements to track progress or benchmark success or to create promotional materials. Impact statements can also be shared with producers or the public at town halls, community meetings, et cetera. So the impact statements you submit to the database have a lot of possible uses. So let's look at how to write a good impact statement. In general, an impact statement is a brief summary in lay terms of the change in knowledge, behavior, or condition created by research, extension, and education efforts. Impact statements don't just share a bunch of data or results or disjointed facts. Impact statements show the bigger picture. They tell the whole story. The Land Grant Impacts Database uses a form with sections and headings to help you fill out your story. We'll go through how to access the database and work with that form in a few minutes, but for now we're going to focus on how to approach each of the sections so that it adds up to a good impact statement. Each impact statement you submit needs a title. Just give your statement a short descriptive title that will help database users know what the impact statement is about. Relevance. In this section, you should explain what is the issue, why is it an issue, and who cares about the issue, or who does the issue affect? Think about keywords that will help readers connect your work to timely or important topics. And keep it short. You only need a few sentences here. Try to limit this section to about 1,000 characters or less. Response. How did the project or program respond to that issue? And who did this work? Again, keep it brief, just a short paragraph or about 1,000 characters. You don't have to account for every single action or every hour of your workday in an impact statement. Your statement should focus on the key actions that addressed the issue and led to impact. And don't give too much detail here about methods or theory. Remember, impact statements are for a non-technical audience. They shouldn't use jargon, abbreviations, acronyms, or technical terms specific to your field. Jargon limits an impact statement to a very specialized audience, but impact statements should be geared toward a lay audience. Results. What were the major results? For example, you might report that a new pesticide is 90% effective, or that 70% of workshop participants met savings goals, or that yields doubled. And then make sure you explain why these things matter. Instead of focusing on how many workshops were given or how many people showed up, impact statements need to go beyond and explain how the project or program created changes in knowledge, behavior, or condition. A change in knowledge might mean that farmers learned new skills at an extension workshop, or that your work provided a foundation for advances in your field. Impacting behavior might mean that farmers started using new tools, or kids increased fruit consumption, or that research findings led to new policy. A change in condition can be a change in economic condition, like farmer profits increasing, or environmental condition, like fewer pollutants in an area's water, or social condition, like improved health or well-being. The key is change. These are the kinds of changes or impacts that funders and stakeholders want to see being reported in the database. And then make sure to include context for the impacts you share. Where did the impact occur? For example, Larimer County, Colorado, or coastal states. How big was the impact? Impact statements should use numbers throughout so that an audience can fully appreciate the magnitude or scale of the work that was done. Who was impacted? For example, potato farmers or high school students. The bulk of your impact statement should be spent in this section, explaining the impact of the project or program. So this can be a longer paragraph, maybe about 2,000 characters or less. If you stick to those character limits for each section, the whole impact statement will be about one page in length, which is a good target. Impact statements in the National Impact Database also ask for public value statements. Impact statements can focus on a particular group who participated in a program, or a certain type of stakeholder, or a specific area that was directly impacted. Public value statements go beyond that and tell why the research or program matters to the general public or a broader area. And it's a good idea to try to describe that public value. Ideally, you should try to report observed, measured impacts, but often newer projects or programs or certain types of research may not have those quantifiable impacts yet. In these cases, you should still describe general or potential impacts. Who are the most likely benefactors of your work? When do you expect outcomes and why? Show that the project or program is a first step toward impact. You might think about describing a ripple effect. Show how initial or small changes have potential to build and spread into bigger impacts over time. Show how your piece of the puzzle contributes to the bigger picture. You could even relate anecdotes as example success stories. What works for one person may work for many. Just be sure to strike a balance between conveying the greater purpose of your work and not overhyping the results. Writing good impact statements also means being prepared. Projects and programs should plan ahead and be prepared to measure and report impacts. And then pay attention to calls for impact statements from your institution, from communicators, or from the National Impact Database team, and share your impact statements in a timely manner. Each institution has a designated user or inputter who is authorized to submit impact statements. If you are not an authorized inputter, you will send your impact statements to the designee for your institution. So I'm going to pull up the database now and show you how to submit an impact statement. So if you are a designated inputter and would like to add an impact statement to the database, just go to landgrantimpacts.org, scroll down to the bottom, to the footer, and click enter the database. You can then enter your login email address and password. And this will bring up your My Impacts profile, which will look a bit different for different users. So to submit an impact statement, click the Add Statement button, and then select the institution the statement is for. In this case, I work on statements for Hatch multi-state research projects, so the option for me says Research National. Most users will select your institution and either research or extension. And then this will bring up that impact statement form. So fill out the sections of the form according to those guidelines that I just shared. And then after you've filled in your text, it's important to fill in the additional information on the form. This is important for organizing impact statements and improving search results. It's important to select a primary focus area. Your impact statement could fall into one of six categories: agricultural systems, energy and bioproducts, environmental stewardship, food security, nutrition and health, or youth, family, and communities. So select one of those focus areas, and it will pop up a bunch of tags where you can further categorize your impact statement. So click on a few of those. Then you can also select a secondary focus area if you'd like. Be sure to scroll back up to the top and continue filling out this additional information. Be sure to select the primary funding source. And then if needed, you can select a secondary funding source. If the impact took place in an urban county, you can indicate that here. The statement year is the year you're entering the impact statement. And then assign a contact. If you as the inputter or submitter are the primary point of contact, you can just check the box and it will populate those fields with your contact information. Or you can manually enter in a different contact's information, maybe the lead scientist or the extension educator involved in the impact statement you submitted. If the impact statement is a collaboration with another institution, you can click that it's an integrated impact statement and then select the institution that the collaboration was with. If you want to provide a short synopsis or kind of a one-line summary of the impact statement, you can do so here. And then resource links are really important. You can just type in a URL here, maybe for a study website or a publication or an infographic or photos about your project or program, and click the plus button and it will attach that resource to the impact statement. If you want to make sure your work is saving as you go, you can use the save and continue editing button. If you need to come back later to finish your impact statement, you can select save and close. And then make sure to hit save and submit when done. And this will automatically send your statement into the review process. So when you submit an impact statement, it will be reviewed by a designated reviewer. Reviewers are asked to review and share suggested edits within 1 week. So watch for emails requesting revisions to your submitted impact statements and make those revisions in a timely manner. You can also log into your My Impacts profile and look at the status column to check the status of the impact statements you've submitted. It will say public when it's been approved and made publicly available. And you'll also receive an email notification when the impact statement has been made publicly available. And that's it. Your impact statement is now in the database and ready to help showcase the importance and value of the land grant system.